and welcome to The Loop. I'm Matt Bruning.
And I'm Erin McBride. Work to repair the Brent Spence Bridge in Cincinnati is just over halfway complete. A fiery crash closed the bridge just a couple weeks ago.
The bridge is a vital link between Ohio and Kentucky, carrying I-71 and I-75 over the Ohio River. ODOT Director Jack Marchbanks joined Kentucky Transportation Cabinet Secretary Jim Gray for an update on the project and to talk about the future plans for that corridor.
You and I both know that there seems to be a lot of different stories about the Brent Spence Bridge. I've discovered in the short time that I've been in my role that the bridge itself is actually safe and sound and sturdy. It's a matter of capacity. And the plan has always been to add a companion bridge to relieve the congestion that's on the bridge today.
We have been working on the Ohio side of the river since 2015, and Governor DeWine is absolutely committed to the advancement of a companion bridge that will improve mobility, safety, and economic development for the people of Northern Kentucky and Southwest Ohio and this entire region.
KYTC expects to have the Brent Spence Bridge repaired and reopened by Christmas. You can find detour information and updates at BrentSpenceRepair.com.
When snow and ice flies, you probably think of the plow truck drivers. But did you know there's an entire team of men and women behind the scenes keeping them on the road?
Our Who Knew Guru shows us the very important role our mechanics play.
You know, plowing snow and ice, that's one of our most important operations all year round. And our drivers are amazing at it. However, they wouldn't be able to perform at such a high level if it weren't for our mechanics. Like my man over here, Corey, with no E, Meadows. What's up, Corey?
Oh man, thanks a lot, Dave. Hey, nice shades, by the way. Hey, we're over here, District 7. We're rocking it out. The mechanics out there, nothing but the best. We got multiple vehicles in this state that we gotta keep track of, keep under control, and keep running throughout the whole winter season event. So what we've got multiple setups, multiple controls, and multiple different styles of trucks, and our mechanics are on their A game to keep that running, to keep them drivers in that seat all winter long. Let me show you around the truck real quick. Obviously a snowplow is no good without a blade. You gotta keep these heavy blades intact so we can keep it moving on the road. The better the blade, the better the cut. Obviously without a good running engine, just like the old Ticker, you gotta keep it going good. That's what our mechanics do, we keep them going. We keep all the fluids up top. We keep everything running top notch right here at ODOT. With everything else, you've got to have a control system. These days, it's all electronic just like everything else. We've got three main hydraulic electronics. We got the Force America system, the Muncie system, and the Penguin system, which is all special to their own, which we keep going at all times. So with our salt control systems, you got have to have a way to get that salt on the road. So this is one of our tailgate spinners. This is just one of multiple varieties that we use to get that salt from the bed of this truck onto that road surface.
Thanks, Corey. Very educational, man. So as you can see, those are just some of the very important items that our mechanics do to maintain these trucks and keep the drivers in the seats. Who knew?
Thanks a lot, Dave, and again, thank you to all those great mechanics across the state. Well, this week has been National Older Driver Safety Awareness Week, and researchers believe that by the year 2025, one in four drivers will be over the age of 65. A decade ago, this segment of the population accounted for 18% of Ohio's traffic deaths. Last year, that increased to 23%.
At ODOT, we've been doing things to make our roads safer, not only for older drivers, but all drivers, like increasing the reflectivity and visibility of our road signs. And this year, ODOT launched a new pilot project to install and evaluate a new type of pavement marking.
While the paint used by ODOT and its contractors must meet certain criteria for retro reflectivity, a different type of paint that's meant to show up even better on dark, rainy nights has recently been used in some parts of the state. Here in District 10 in southeastern Ohio, it was recently used right here on State Route 60 in Washington County, as well as on State Route 7. It's called wet reflective paint, and it contains special glass beads that have a higher retro reflection value than other paint. In other words, drivers can see the road better and the risk of crashes is reduced. There are plans to use it on other routes in Athens, Gallia, Meigs, and Washington counties. In Washington County, I'm Ashley Rittenhouse for The Loop.
Thanks, Ashley. Studies show that markings can reduce crashes up to 46%.
Get more ODOT news online at transportation.ohio.gov. Follow us on social media, and we always love your story ideas and feedback to loop@dot.ohio.gov.
And now, you're in The Loop.